weird.
What?
Right under my tongue.
Alex, you're gonna have to pull it.
Lori, we need to wake up.
I'm gonna bring you back now on 1, 2, taking another deep breath on 3. Eyes open. There you go. It's okay.
I'm gonna go in there now.
Did you recall that much detail beforehand, or
no? Not like this.
Really wanted to just kind of focus on this implant.
If there is an implant under Rob's tongue, it could be giving off radio signals. This tool will pick them up.
Okay, so I'm not seeing anything coming out of it.
The meter isn't picking anything up, but that doesn't mean there's nothing there. Rob will have to get an X-ray to make sure.
So Rob, you gave us so much great information. We have our sketch artist here. Vicky, what do we have first? Okay, wow, cool. Can you see this?
Oh yeah, this is totally spot on.
These are really like the hands?
The hands, yeah. Cool.
Is the head that angular?
It's very triangular, right? Uh-huh. Very triangular, and the eyeballs dominate the head.
Much bigger than what people describe with the grays, right?
Oh yeah, a lot bigger. It seems like the eyes define the shape of the head.
This is the stuff, honestly, that nightmares are made of.
Though Rob's alien doesn't resemble Calvin's, both men recalled under hypnosis that they were implanted with a device in their nose or mouth, an uncanny similarity.
Thank you for your time. Thank you for dedicating some time to take him back into that very kind of uncomfortable place.
Another day at the office.
There's a widespread rumor in ufology circles that I've always been curious about. It's believed that President Dwight D. Eisenhower signed a peace treaty with an alien race in 1954 that might have allowed for human abductions. I mean, if this is true, it would be an explosive revelation. So I'm going to continue my investigation by speaking with Laura Eisenhower, President Eisenhower's great-granddaughter.
Hi there.
Hey, Laura, how's it going?
Pretty good. How are you?
Good, good. Hey, thank you for meeting with me. I've heard a lot about some rumors that I'm hoping you can either confirm or deny for me. I'm just going to come right out and ask you, do you believe that your great-grandfather, Dwight D. Eisenhower, signed a treaty with extraterrestrials?
It's a true story. What I have learned about Eisenhower's relationship to extraterrestrial beings and ET government treaties is that supposedly in 1954 there was a meeting at Edwards Air Force Base.
Right.
They seemed to have diplomatic intention. The treaties had to do with bartering exchanges of planetary goods, natural resources, elements, and compounds. And it was in exchange for like things like abduction.
Why would they want to abduct humans? What are they doing with that?
But they need our DNA. We have a treasure of DNA that is basically a living library.
Laura Eisenhower explains that aliens wish to analyze our DNA in their quest to unlock the secrets of the universe, which they believe is hidden in the DNA of all living creatures.
It's interesting you say that because the abductees that I've talked to, that seems to be a very common theme. If you were in your grandfather's place, I mean, do you have a better understanding? Do you blame him for what he did?
I am not here to protect anybody. I know that he just had no idea what he was dealing with at the time.
Right.
How could anybody truly process the larger picture of all this?
What do you think the government loses by telling the American public and giving full disclosure about these treaties and the abductions? Why are they trying to sweep it under the rug and hide it?
You're gonna have your well-intentioned people that are trying to do their best for humanity, that are aware of what's going on to a certain degree, and they are being heavily stopped from being able to put out disclosure. Plus, what they have to lose is their life.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Laura just gave me so much information. A lot of this is difficult to swallow, but if this information is true, the aliens have made treaties with the U.S. government, it's no doubt that the government does not want the people to know about it.
Hey, Calvin, how's it going?
Hey, good, Ben. Look, the reason I called you, there's something happened. Another witness has come forward. Seen it and all, described everything.
This is somebody who saw the event where you were fishing. You say there's a lady who saw something?
Absolutely. We have checked her out, and she is really a good, credible witness. Has held this in for a long time.
This is really great. Thank you for reaching out.
Oh, thank you.
Calvin just told me that a second witness turned up. Apparently a woman saw something he did. I can't wait to talk to her.
Ben was able to get in touch with the witness. Although she didn't want to appear on camera, she was willing to provide a recorded statement.
Hello? This is... I heard you were looking into the abduction case of 1973. On the night of October 11th, 1973, I was actually parked near the bank of the Pascagoula River with my husband. I was dropping him off at the docks where he worked as a fisherman. We both saw a blue light in the sky moving back and forth. I got out of the car, and I know this sounds crazy, but I saw something in the water. It looked like a person, but there was something different about it. I think it was an alien. What Calvin Parker described was exactly what I saw.
I'm glad we found an eyewitness after all these years to corroborate Calvin's story, but it makes a government inaction all the more frustrating. I think if he'd been taken seriously back in 73, it wouldn't have taken 40 years for these eyewitnesses to come forward. Laura's revelations about the government's role in these abductions is terrifying. There are thousands of possible victims out there, but luckily for Rob, they learn to give each other the support they don't get elsewhere. Rob's hypnotherapist has put him in touch with a support group of other abduction survivors. Amazingly, many of the alleged abductees report similar experiences.
Yeah, my name's Valerie. I had an experience with one of the huge triangular shaped crafts to the point where I feel like I need to educate myself more.
Many of the abductees believe the aliens target multiple generations of the same family.
Most of these life forms have extensive lifespans compared to the typical human. They track people in family lines because of their lifespan. They can't possibly study everything they want to study with a normal human's lifespan. The human beings are implanted with tracking devices. That's been going on for a very long time.
My family would tell me something, and like, for example, my dad would be like, I had a dream where I woke up. Yeah, you had a dream where you woke up, first of all, right? And then he's like, I'm walking through the house and these little guys are chasing me around. I'm like, oh, that really happened, Dad.
It's generational, and it's the same. If it's been happening to him, this has been happening a lot longer than at work. They made an aluminum hat for me. And, you know, people don't want to believe. I don't care if you believe me or not, you know.
Occasionally, someone will say, you're a complete liar, whatever. And all you have to do is look at them and say, you have to have your own experience.
Yeah, thank you. So that was helpful.
My investigation into alien abductions has been fascinating. Many of them believe that they have received implants, that the aliens are coming back, and that it's multi-generational, and that the government will not listen to their stories.
They're under my tongue.
Also, I was surprised to hear the reports of multiple species abducting people. Betty and Barney Hill had the Greys, Rob had the Mantis, and whatever you call the monstrosity that came for Calvin, it really makes me wonder what's going on up there. Calvin still feels at risk.
I sleep 3 hours at night. I want to be up to protect my family.
But how at risk are the rest of us of being abducted? And based on what Laura told me, if it's true, how complicit is the government? Are they conspiring with aliens? So many questions remain. We deserve to know the truth.